Hello.
How are you?
I am so good. How are you?
Fantastic. Thanks for making time today. I appreciate it.
Thanks for making time for me.
Anytime. I'm so excited, Priscilla, because you look great. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
I'm going to jump into the music. I'm going to jump into the EP, and then we'll talk about the Opry and all of that. First, let's start with Just About Over You. Phenomenal song, which obviously had this viral sensation to it. Can you walk me through? Because here's the other thing that people might not know. You've been doing music for a long time. You moved to Nashville when you were 18. You've been doing sold out shows. But then all of a sudden, this song kind of blows up on TikTok. Talk to me about all of this.
Yeah, I mean, I moved to Nashville right out of high school. I was just this young girl that wanted to be an artist and wanted to be a songwriter, and have spent the past 7 years just grinding it out, you know, playing any show that anybody would let me play, riding with my friends, just kind of like the whole thing. And Just About Over You was the song that kind of blew up. I mean, I think blow up might be an understatement. You know, I was really heavily diving into TikTok throughout the pandemic, because when the pandemic hit, I was doing music basically full time, and I was cleaning Airbnbs. And so my income was gone. Right. I mean, so, you know, there's this app, this dancing app that I think, and I decide, I mean, God knows I can't dance. I'm like, I wonder what would be the response if I put up my own music on here.
Right.
And it just steadily started growing and growing and growing and growing. And Just About Over You was the song that I put on there. And I mean, hundreds of fans crowdfunded me to record that song. And the next day it was number one on the iTunes all genre charts. And it's just, it's insane.
And now, because of that, you've got all of this stuff going on. I mean, that's unbelievable, Priscilla, isn't it?
It really is. I mean, it's funny. I mean, when that happened and everybody started calling, labels are calling, and everyone's like, "Who's this girl? Like, is this fake?"
Right.
It's like, is it bots? I learned what bots were. People thought I had bots. I'm like, no, I cannot afford my rent. I just had to move out of my apartment because I'm so broke.
Right.
And it was insane.
All right. Well, let's talk about this EP, which I'm really excited about. I love every single song on this EP, but I'm going to go down a couple of my favorites here. Let's talk about Wish You Were the Whiskey. And I'm high. It's rocking me through the night, keeping me warm. Tell me about this song. And really, there's kind of a theme through the EP. It's almost like a heartbreak breakup, but also moving on kind of theme through the EP. Talk to me about this.
Yes. Wish You Were the Whiskey is a song that I wrote 2.5 years ago. And I wrote the song for Jason Aldean. And it's actually funny. Never got a hold of him. me and my friends, we had all kind of reached a point where we're like, none of our stuff is working. Maybe we should try and write a song for somebody else.
Right.
And so with this song, it was like Jason Aldean all day, every day. Well, never got it to him. We didn't know anybody in the business. And I was like, you know what? When it came time for this EP, I'm like, I'm going to cut that song.
It's a great song. Has he heard it yet? Do you know if he's heard it?
No, I don't know if he's heard it. I mean, I have done everything to try and get it in his hands. I mean, there was like a year ago, I posted it on TikTok and I was like, tag Brittany Aldean in this and maybe like she would hear it and like show it to him. It's just, I mean, whatever, right?
It's a phenomenal song. My personal favorite on the album is Sad Girls Do Sad Things.
What's past is past. Am I over? Am I lonely? All I know is that this ain't who I want to be. I guess sad girls do sad things.
Vulnerable, and it's raw and it's emotional. Tell me about this one.
Gosh, thank you. I love this song so much, and it was one of those that I didn't know if I was going to put on the EP, and I kind of had this moment. There was another song in place. And I was like, I think I need to put Sad Girls on there. And, you know, this song is almost like, I went through a time in my life where I was like a sad girl, like sad girl. And it's funny because people think that I'm like, because I am so out there and I am the life of the party, I felt like it was important for me to put this song on my EP to show people that like, I have gone through some really sad times of life and done things that I'm not proud of. And it's almost like the song that was like a forgiveness to myself. And the song starts and ends with the line, like, don't get me wrong. I love a beer on a Friday, but lately I've been at the bar more than my place. And it's like, I'm a bar girl. I hang out at the bars all the time. But there's a complete difference when you're hanging out at the bar happy versus when you're hanging out at the bar sad.
100%. Well, it's truthfully, I was listening to the EP last night and I'm listening to the whole thing. And when I got to that song, I stopped about 15 seconds in and then restarted it because I was like, hold on a second.
My gosh.
This song is unbelievable. So congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's talk about the Opry.
Oh my gosh.
Before I get your reaction on performing there, I want to know because we all have one. What is your very first Opry memory? First one you can think of.
I went and saw Carrie Underwood play with my roommate. She had some extra tickets and we went and saw her play and it was like, oh my gosh.
Okay, now to you performing. And by the way, somebody's roommate and somebody's sister, they're going to get in tickets to come and see you play.
I'm so excited. I'm, you know, this is one of those dreams that you have as a country artist to hopefully play that stage. And I'm so excited. My whole family's flying out for it. I feel so honored to even be invited to play there.
Are you nervous at all?
Oh, dude, I'm like terrified. I'm going to pee my pants.
I would.
Seriously.
No doubt.
I'm like, am I going to be able to not cry the whole time?
Right.
Don't know.
Right. We'll find out when we get there. Tell me the story about Taylor Swift that I read. Because actually, there's more to it than just Taylor Swift helped you kind of move on. Really, there was a moment where you called your sister and you were like, time to come home, right? Can you tell me what was going on in your life, if you're willing to open up about that, where you were like, hey, might be time to back out of this thing, and then walk me through the Taylor Swift thing.
Yeah. So everyone that knows me knows I am such a Taylor Swift fan, and I have been since I started playing music. Those were the first songs that I learned on guitar. And a huge reason why I moved to Nashville, my first year in town was terrible. I mean, like bad to worse, like house got broken into the first weekend I moved to Nashville. I was this 18-year-old girl that knew nobody, did not know where to start. It was just like lost.
Yeah.
And anyway, I was working at this yogurt shop from 9 to 5. And then I would go to community college from 6 to 9. And that day I had called my sister. I literally remember it like it was yesterday. It was rainy outside, just gross. And I was like, I do not know what I'm doing out here. Like I moved out here to do music. I'm not doing music. I'm a year in. I can barely pay my bills. I'm like the biggest people person ever. And I don't know how to make friends.
Yeah.
And that day, Taylor Swift was driving by, and I was wearing a Taylor Swift t-shirt, and she pulled her car. I was leaving work. She pulled her car over to the side of the road and jumped into her passenger seat, like over her middle console, jumped into her passenger seat, put her car in park. He was like, I love your shirt. And I'm standing there like, oh my gosh, I'm going to be late for class. And of course I had to rush to get to class because I had to go to the computer lab to print out this English paper because my laptop had been stolen.
Oh my gosh.
So I was like rushing to get there. At that point, I'm like, man, I don't even care if I go. And that was the moment I looked at her and I was like, thank you so much. I don't even think I told her I did music. I remember I went to class. Of course I was late. And I was just sitting there and I'm like, I am quitting my job. I'm quitting school. I'm going to go figure out how to pay my bills and I'm going to go do music.
Wow. Unbelievable. What would you say was your worst job that you had while you were trying to pay bills and all of that?
Oh my gosh. Well, you know, I have done like every job. I mean, I'll find stuff on the side of the road, sell it on Craigslist, like literally anything you can think of.
Yep.
Dumpster diving, me. The worst job, which is so funny because I'm such like a dog lover, was dog sitting. Because here's the thing. I wanted to either keep all the dogs.
Yep.
I don't want to, even babysitting's hard for me. I don't want to get this baby back. It's like, that was me with dog sitting. And once I had this dog that literally almost like died on me, it was like a super duper old dog. And when the girl dropped her dog off, I'm like, oh my, her dog like might die. Like could be blind, could not walk, having seizures. I'm like, oh my gosh. It's crazy. I'm a dog girl, but I do not want a dog sit anymore.
A good answer. That's a unique answer. I didn't expect that one.
I know, it's kind of shocking to people.
Let's do some quick fire questions, get to know you a little bit better.
Let's number do one it.
What is the best concert you've ever been to as a fan?
Taylor Swift.
Number Fearless. Two, I should have known that. Number two, what does the perfect night out look like for you?
A dive bar, cheap beer, and karaoke.
You know, it's interesting. I find it's very interesting now what people call a dive bar. Can you tell me what a dive bar is in your opinion? Because there's two different types.
Here's a dive bar. A dive bar is a place that you can go to and there's not a line wrapped around the building. Also a place that you can find some cold, cold beer. I'm not talking like kind of cold, like ice cold beer, and making sure that there's a jukebox there. That's the dive bar. And you know what? The rougher the floors, the better for me.
If you walk in and you don't really necessarily want to touch the walls, that's how you know it's a dive bar and it's going to be excellent. It's going to be
exactly
a great
day, right? Yeah.
Number three, who was your first celebrity crush?
Ooh. It was either, I think Luke Bryan.
Sure.
Bryan or Justin Bieber.
Those are two different ends of the spectrum.
You know what? That just goes to show I don't have a specific type. You know, maybe somebody that can sing and somebody that looks good.
Right. Number four, when something amazing happens in your life, who's the first person that you want to tell?
My best friend, Kara.
Number five, when's the last time you had too much to drink?
Probably last night.
What were you doing?
I'm just kidding. Not last night, but I don't know, maybe a couple nights ago.
Having fun.
Having fun. Why not? I feel like there's so much to celebrate right now that I'm like, hot bottles, baby.
As you should. All right, really quick. And then last thing, I'll let you go talk to other people. I know you're a big Taylor Swift fan, so I want to have some fun here and I want to play some clips and I want you to tell me the memory or the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear these songs. Okay.
Oh my gosh. Look at you. Here love it. He's a reason for the teardrops on my guitar.
The only thing that keeps me wishing on a wishing star. All right, what's the first thing you think about?
Oh my gosh. Her curly hair. Like the ringlet curls.
Long curly hair.
Yes, sure. Yes.
Okay, here we go. Number two. Go.
The castle. I think of a castle. Yeah. Did you ever see that music video?
I did. Yeah. Great. Yeah. I've seen all of them. Huge fan myself. All right. Last one.
Getting back together. Like ever.
I knew you would.
All I think is, and he calls me up and he's like, I still love you. And I'm like,
I love it.
That's what I think of right when I hear that song.
Priscilla, thank you so much for the time. Genuinely, I mean this seriously. I listened to the whole EP and every single song is really, really good. I'm so happy for you and I can't wait to play the single and hopefully see you live sometime soon.
Thank you so much. Your support means the world and I'm just, wow. Like, you're amazing. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a great rest of your day.
All right. You too. Bye.